Hello guys, good morning. Today we're going to do some evaluation or attempting to repair this unit. This is Fujitsu is Primo slim type desktop. So the customer concerned this is it will turn on but suddenly will shut down. So I'm not sure I can fix it today, but I will show you how to identify the defective components so that you have idea before you make a decision where to buy the spare parts or to buy a new one. So let's check. Insert the BGA, the keyboard. Keyboard and the mouse. Make sure to turn off, then turn it, plug the power, then turn the switch on. So as you notice, he already power up. Even I did not press the power, so there is something wrong with the system unit. As I suspected, this was a grounded motherboard, or the PSU is defective. So I have two suspected parts. So we'll first check on the minimum requirements for checking the RAM and the connectors. Then we'll do a test for alternative PSU. Okay. So you can see there's two slots RAM. So we'll check if the RAM cause this error. So automatically on, then sudden turn off. So nothing wrong with the RAM, because even if the RAM is out, the computer will indicate the beep that the RAM is missing, but there is no power, so there's nothing wrong with the RAM. Next, with the connector. So I suspected also there are some grounded connectors or shorted. So I already pull it out. So, and also the hard disk. So we can now identify that there is nothing wrong with these components, the hard disk and the CD-ROM. So not shorted. Suddenly turn on. So we will try to use alternative PSU, the ATX PSU. I already searched on the internet about the alternative for testing only. So if the ATX PSU is compatible with this kind of system unit, so I saw in the some website saying that as long as it was fit and the wires color are exact, so I searched it, then it was exact color and the wires also. So I will disconnect the main connector, the 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18. It's a 24 pin and the 4 pin. So this is common for ATX PSU. So I have here PSU. This is working PSU from ATX computer. So we will connect the 24 pin and the 4 pin. So okay. So we'll try to plug power. Turn it on. So same scenario. So even I replace the PSU, the ATX PSU, the same scenario will occur. So therefore, I conclude that there's nothing wrong with the power supply, and the hard disk and the CD-ROM. So the possibilities of this error would be the motherboard. So I suspectedly there's a defective component inside the motherboard who is shorted and need to replace. So in the processor side it is intact, so I have no doubt about the processor, but the motherboard probably. So to verify, we will reset the CMOS battery. So this is one method also to make first action in terms of troubleshooting. So there are times that it will work by resetting the CMOS, but not always scenario, but we will try. So I already reset the CMOS battery. And let's turn it on. So that's it. Even we reset the CMOS battery, the same problem was occurred. So therefore, I'm sure that this motherboard is grounded, and probably there are some defective CMD components here that shorted. So this the next procedure will be sent to the electronics technician to identify the defective components on the motherboard. So hope this video will help you on how to identify and to do basic troubleshooting on computer. Please subscribe, and you may also like and comments to our YouTube. So thank you.